Hello, and welcome to the definitive Crazy Taxi tutorial. My name is Du, and I'm going to teach you how to be a bona fide Crazy Taxi master like myself. So I've been playing Crazy Taxi now since about 2003, so about 18 years at the time of recording this. Most of my life, for sure. But I've only been playing seriously for about 6 years now, just before I started making videos on Crazy Taxi, which was about 5 years ago at this point. And yeah, I'm pretty passionate about Crazy Taxi. I love this game. I think it's one of the best, if not the best, arcade games ever made. And I want to help other people become good Crazy Taxi players, and hopefully this guide will be very helpful. There are a lot of subtle tricks and cues you need to know in order to succeed in Crazy Taxi and take your gameplay to the next level, I guess. So the first thing I'm going to go over really quickly is what is the differences between the four characters. Easily one of the most common questions I get on videos and sometimes when I stream Crazy Taxi, people ask me that is what is the difference between the four characters. So there's four characters in the game, obviously: Axel, Beady Joe, Gina, and Gus. Axel is kind of the all-rounder, the basic character, I guess. He's got pretty good acceleration, pretty good handling. He's actually a lightweight character. He doesn't feel There's two light characters, Gina and Axel, but he doesn't really feel as light as Gina. But his cab is also wide. Two of the characters are wide, and two of them are kind of narrow. Doesn't make a huge difference, but obviously with a wider cab, you're at a slightly greater risk of running into stuff. So it can make a little bit of a difference, but I'd say generally not that big of a deal. BD Joe, he's the fastest character in the game. He's got the fastest, like, normal speed. He's really fast at accelerating. He's also heavy, which is a good thing because he allows you to plow through, like, traffic, kind of get messed up less when you run into things. But he's very slippery. He's easily the easiest to turn with, but he can easiest to overturn with as well. So worth mentioning that for sure. That's easily his biggest pro and con at the same time, is how slippery he is. And we go on to Gina, who is I think she's got the best acceleration and deceleration, and she's got really good braking and pretty good handling overall. Her biggest flaw, though, is that she's the lightest character in the game, and she definitely feels it feels very punishing to run into stuff with Gina, like other cars. You can really get messed up. You lose your momentum much more easily with Gina than you do with any of the other characters, even though Axel is also supposed to be light. They don't really feel like they're the same. And I think her drifting is actually not as good, if I remember the crazytaxi.net character overviews, but that's not really something I've ever noticed personally while playing with her. But she does have very good handling, though, and she does feel pretty good to play with overall. And then we go on to Gus, who is easily the best character in the game. The general consensus amongst Crazy Taxi players seems to be that Gus is the best, usually Gus or Beady Joe. And I definitely lean towards Gus. He's easily my favorite character to play as. He's the heaviest. He has really good handling and good traction. His only downsides are that he's slow and he takes a while to stop, but these are things that you could easily mitigate once you learn how to use the skills in the game. Like, once you learn how to properly boost, his slower speed doesn't actually make a difference because all the characters go kind of have, I think they have all have like the same like high-end speed while you're boosting anyway, so it doesn't actually matter that he's the slowest character. So he doesn't actually have as many cons as a lot of the other characters do. But obviously without mastering the skills, he is a little bit harder to use. But his heavy weight and good like traction allows him to kind of bully other cars off the road a lot more easily. And he's a little bit better off-roading, even though there's not really that much off-roading you have to do in Crazy Taxi. It makes a little bit of a difference. So that's a basic rundown of the four characters. And now we're going to move over into the skills section. I'm going to be going over how to do all of the skills that you need to succeed in this game. And I should mention I'm playing on emulator, and I'm playing the GameCube version. I have a GameCube controller display on screen. I know not everybody who's playing this game is going to be playing on GameCube or with a GameCube controller, But obviously the stick is going to be steering. B is how you shift into reverse. A is how you shift into drive. L is the brake, and R is the gas. So you can use that controller display there to translate that over to whatever other controller you're using, or keyboard, or whatever, since a lot of people do also play on PC, like the Steam release. Yeah, so let's move on to the skills themselves. So we're going into arcade. I'm gonna go for 10 minutes. I think I'll pick Axel since he is kind of the poster boy of Crazy Taxi, and I am wearing my Axel shirt, so only makes sense. I'm gonna make a save state here too. So the first and most important skill you need to know when playing Crazy Taxi is the Crazy Dash and the Limit Cut. Like before I knew how to Crazy Dash, like I would play the game, I knew how to actually dash from a standstill, which is like this, but I didn't know you could actually keep like dashing as you're driving. I would just drive around like this, like regular acceleration, regular speed. And obviously that's really slow and really terrible. You don't want to go slow. You want to go fast in this game because going fast saves time, and time is everything when playing on arcade. You want to get as much time as possible and waste as little time as possible. Oh, look at that nice view. Okay. So yeah, the crazy dash. So in order to perform a crazy dash at a standstill here, you just shift into reverse. And that guy's gonna get really annoying really quickly. So you shift into reverse, and then you shift into drive and hit the gas at the same time. So we'll do that again. You can see there, you kind of take off a little bit. So shift into reverse, shift into drive, and hit the gas. I think I have a slight delay when I actually hit the gas between after hitting the accelerator, but it's very quick. I think that's just how I do it. I don't know if it actually matters. Yeah, I hit him at the same time there, and it's the same thing. Just kind of comfortable on the GameCube controller to like do it like that with like that rhythm, I guess. Which moves me on to the next thing. So that's the crazy dash. You can actually keep doing crazy dashes while you're driving the same exact way. You just need to keep in mind, and this is the part that I think trips up a lot of people, because I've been asked this quite a few times over the years too, like, how do you move so fast? How do you keep doing like dashes while you're driving? And I think the thing that really messes or trips people up a lot is that you need to have a slight pause. Let's move here. And then I'm going to shift into reverse, and then I'm going to do a dash. So what you want to avoid doing, I guess, is doing it instantly. There we go, like that time there. It's really hard for me to actually do it the wrong way because it's like programmed into me after doing so many limit cuts and crazy dashes over the years, probably tens of thousands of them at this rate, at this point. So we're gonna move. So dash while you're moving, you're gonna go into reverse. Just a slight pause, like a quarter of a second. I don't really know the exact timing. It's just something you kind of got to get a feel for, but just remember you have to pause before you actually hit reverse and the gas again. So reverse, pause, drive, and gas. Just like that. And that's how you do a crazy dash. So limit cut is basically a crazy dash, but it's something you only really perform while you're going at your highest speed. It's one of those things that I don't really fully understand, to be honest. While you're going at the highest speed you can dash and do a limit cut, which allows you to go even faster than that. I think most of the time I just crazy dash anyways, instead of doing limit cuts. Like, I don't know if I'm doing limit cuts or crazy dashes a lot of the time, which kind of brings me on to another point. I believe in the Dreamcast and the original arcade, well, I know actually, I don't believe. I know for a fact that the sounds are different in those versions of the game than they are in the GameCube and the PlayStation 2 versions. And the cab actually makes like the engine makes a revving noise when you successfully do a crazy dash, and I'm pretty sure a limit cut as well. You could see that the cab also, while you dash, the cab kind of jostles around a bit. That's kind of how you know. I think that's a limit cut there, when you actually jostle around a lot, as opposed to just doing a regular dash. Okay, so that's the crazy dash. Easily the most important skill you need to learn, because speed is key to be a good Crazy Taxi player. Another skill that's very similar to the Crazy Dash, but not one that I personally use very often. I do it accidentally quite a bit, but it definitely can be useful in certain situations, so I'll teach you how to do it anyways. And that is the Crazy Back Dash. That's basically going to be the same thing as doing a Crazy Dash, but we're going to go backwards instead. And the execution is very similar, so while we're stopped and in reverse, we're going to switch into drive, hit the gas, and then while holding the gas, quickly switch back into reverse. So, just like this, you can see we get a lot of, you know, quick, like, backwards momentum. Honestly, this is a very niche and situational skill. It's only really useful if you know there's a customer kind of behind you, and you can kind of confidently drive to wherever they are without looking. I guess kind of like that, because it would be faster in a lot of cases just to do that instead of, say, trying to turn yourself around to get somebody that's behind you. So, kind of situational, but it's definitely useful, and you'll be a better Crazy Taxi player for it if you can actually learn how to do this and kind of program yourself to actually use it. I think that's really the main thing, is I've never programmed myself to use this skill, so I never use it. I just, like, turn around whenever I need to go backwards like that or something. But it is a good skill. So once again, just like the Crazy Dash, we're going to shift into, from reverse, we're going to shift into drive and hit the gas and then shift into reverse right after we execute the dash. And that's how you go backwards. That is the Crazy Back Dash. Next, we're going to do the Crazy Stop, which is another skill that I also don't really use very much, even though I should. Again, because I just never really programmed myself to use it. But once again, it's basically the same thing, but now we're adding same thing as the Crazy, the Back Dash, but we're going to be doing it while moving. And instead of hitting or shifting just into reverse, we're also going to hit the brake at the same time that we shift into reverse. So it's going to be just like this. Or actually, I didn't do the dash portion there. So you want to dash. There, that was kind of a crazy stop, but I was in midair. So it's kind of hard to see. A good way to practice this is to do it kind of at a standstill here while you're not moving. And just kind of, when your cab does that, that's how you know you're doing it right. So just like the dash, you're going to dash, and as soon as you, like, dash, you're going to shift into reverse and hit the brake at the same time. So slam on the brakes and hit reverse. You can see here, that was a crazy stop. Now, when you're not going very fast, you will pretty much just, like, stop on a dime. But while you're moving at, like, top speed, you're still going to slide a little bit. So that's one of the main reasons why I never really use this skill, I think. I'm not really fast enough to react to, like, get somebody, and that's, I think that's the most useful thing about doing a crazy stop would be, like, picking up a customer that when you're looking for somebody to pick up and you, like, are going high speed, you're like, oh, there's somebody right there, and you try to stop for them. I'm just not, like, good enough to do that, I guess. I never really practiced the skill enough, so I never really bothered using it. So because of that, I would say it's not really a super essential skill, but it can definitely come in handy. So just one more time, just like doing the crazy dash, except you're going to, as soon as you dash, you're going to hit reverse and the brakes at the same time. And that is the crazy stop. I'll do another one down here at speed just so you can see what it's like. That was kind of a terrible one. This is a terrible spot. I wish there was, like, a test room or something, a practice room I could go into. Unfortunately, all the... There we go. That was pretty decent, I guess. That is the crazy stop. Now we're going to go on to the turning skills in the game. Obviously, the most important one being the crazy drift. And much like the crazy dash, we're going to be performing this skill by shifting from reverse into drive. But instead, we're not going to take our hands off the accelerator at any point. Or I guess your feet if you're playing on arcade itself. So that right there, that was a crazy drift. Or we can do this. You can kind of spin yourself around any way you want to go. Man, damn it. all you do is shift from reverse into drive and turn the stick whatever direction you want to go. You can see there, it's very quick. Like, I pretty much, I shift like in a tenth of a second, really, from reverse into drive. It's super fast. It doesn't have to be like, there's no pause, there's no real special timing that you have to use in order to actually do it. You just shift just like that. Because I do it like on a GameCube controller with one hand, like literally just like that. I'll just shift from reverse into drive and turn the stick. And then obviously you can, depending on how much you turn it, you know, it kind of depends on how much you drift. Like, if you want to drift like this, say around a corner, you have to turn back the opposite direction. Otherwise, you're just going to spin your cab around all the way like this. So, say I wanted to turn like hard left with a drift. Well, that was not a very good spot to do it. Let's do it down right here. I need to actually make sure I turn the stick back. Well, that was a hard right, I guess. So I turned right. But then I also turned back left so I can keep my cab facing the direction that I actually want to go through the drift. If that makes sense. So yeah, that's basically the crazy drift. Super easy. Maybe takes a little bit getting used to actually use it like precisely the way you want. But very simple, just shifting from reverse into drive. That's like every skill in the game is from shifting from reverse to drive. It's all about timing, really, when it comes to the skills. A good point to know about the crazy drift is you really don't want to be doing crazy drifts around a lot of turns. It kind of depends on the turn, but a lot of times it's faster to just turn like that. Like, just do a regular turn is faster and easier than doing a crazy drift. Crazy drift will allow you to be a bit more precise, have like kind of a bit more control of where you end up, I guess. Like that. See what I mean? It's just slower, though, for like general turning, so you don't want to drift all the time. But you can boost out of a drift as well, so let me do it up here. If I drift and then boom, do that. See, I boosted out of the drift. So you can really, once you learn these, all of the skills, you can really kind of chain them together any way you want or any way you need. If I drift and then do a boost out of a drift, it's a little bit faster, and I'd probably recommend doing that like every time. If you're taking a turn, you should probably boost out of your drift once you turn the corner and are facing the direction you want to be facing. So that brings me on to the next skill, which is this right here. And this is basically a drift, but at a standstill, while we're not moving at all. And this is useful. This is my primary way of turning when I'm at a location that I'm stopped at, and I need to turn around to get like a certain customer or go to a certain location. That's easily the fastest way. Or after I pick somebody up, say I pick up this lady, and I'm facing in this direction, obviously I need to turn around, so the quickest way to do that would just be do this. And this is, it's very simple, so it's basically just like the crazy drift. We're going to shift from reverse into drive, but what's important here is you need to make sure you hold the stick before you do that, otherwise you're just going to do a crazy dash. So hold the stick in the direction you want to turn, and then shift from reverse into drive and hit the gas at the same time. And you can just keep doing this all day, really. Pretty simple skill and very useful. I do this practically non-stop during my games all the time. It's the quickest way to turn around while you're not moving. And yeah, that's the tailspin. I guess the last skill that I'm going to go over here is the back drift, which is not something that's listed on crazytaxi.net, but I'm pretty sure I've seen this listed in other locations, and this is the backdrift there. We got kind of a weird camera angle there. The camera got locked on the side of my cab. This is the backdrift. And this is one of my primary ways to stop at locations, I guess. This and drifting itself. Instead of utilizing crazy stops, I tend to drift into locations, kind of like this. I'll drift around the direction I want to go, or I want to be facing once I drop off the customer. So I'm just going to pretend that I'm actually stopping at a location right here. And just kind of hit the brakes and use the wall in my drift in order to lose my momentum and stop. And the back drift is we're going to be drifting, and we're going to turn the cab all the way around. I don't want you. We're going to drift, turn the cab all the way around, and then shift into reverse. So instead of doing this, like say I wanted to pick up a customer, you could kind of turn yourself all the way around like this, and then boost to turn around really quickly. That's usually how I pick up like customers when I'm looking for somebody, and I'm not sure where anybody is. A backdrift is a pretty useful way to, I guess, kind of pull yourself into a location really quickly. And it's really simple. All you do is drift, turn yourself all the way around, and shift into reverse. Right as you face the cab the other direction, you'll maintain that momentum you had, but in reverse. So, pretty simple skill. Every skill in this game, like I said, is basically variations of shifting from reverse into drive, and playing around with the timing and the accelerator. And that's all of the basic skills, actually. That's everything you need to know as far as controlling the cab is concerned. I guess the next thing I'm going to go over is how to earn tips, I guess. You earn tips through, there's five different ways to really earn tips. The first one here is crazy throughs. Obviously, when you pass a car, any vehicle actually, trains count. I think the trolleys count up here. Let me just actually confirm that. The trolleys do count. Yes, they do. Pass them up really closely without touching them, and you can wrap up your combo that way. Don't underestimate how much crazy throughs can really add up, because they really can, especially over long trips. Obviously, like solid red customers, they go like really short. You're not really have any opportunities to do crazy throughs, but you can really rack up a lot of combos with crazy throughs with long trips, and you can get hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands, I guess, potentially, if you're really good, just with crazy throughs and driving really well. And then the next couple of things you could use to sort of earn tips and get a bigger combo is by doing jumps and drifts. So you can drift. Whenever you perform a drift with a customer in the cab, you earn points. Earn tips, which is very good. And of course, when you get air, I guess I can use that little jump right there instead of going down those hills. You also get tips. The jumps aren't really that important, since there's only like certain areas you can actually do jumps at anyways. But still, good to know you get tips from doing it. So if you ever pass one of those little, I guess, tow trucks or whatever that's set up like a ramp, you get a couple of extra tips. And those are the basic ways to earn money, or earn extra money, I guess, with customers. And the more advanced methods would be wall sticking and doing a, I think it's also referred to as a backdrift, but I believe that's what it's called. Don't quote me on this, because I don't actually know how to do a backdrift, so I'm not going to show you how to do it. But I will explain what it is. First, let's go over wall sticks. And wall sticks are maybe a little controversial. Perhaps some people might not agree that wall sticks should be allowed. I personally think they are, and or should be. And all a wall stick is drifting into a wall and getting stuck on it. Well, if I can actually show it off, that'd be nice. I was kind of hoping this customer would, just like this, there we go. It's a very simple and easy thing to do, and an easy way to gain a lot of money. The only downside is, obviously, it takes up a lot of time. So it probably isn't good to do this all of the time. You could really see the potential here. So I got this lady, it's at 2,000. And I think I still actually have enough time. Oh, no, well, I would've. I would've had enough time if I went the right way, but I got her to over 2,000 by basically doing nothing. So you can see how, if along the way, you can get a lot of crazy throughs and build up a big combo and then finish off the customer with a big wall stick, you can easily get a lot of money. So that's wall sticking. I like doing wall sticks. I think wall sticks should be allowed in general Crazy Taxi play, since it's basically a mechanic. But it's kind of a punishing, kind of rewarding. It's a high risk, high reward kind of thing, where it takes up a lot of time and there's some RNG involved as well. Like, some walls aren't really as good for wall sticking, and sometimes you just don't get good wall sticks. So because of those elements, I don't really see, I think it's like broken or anything. But the other way to earn tips, the back drift, in my opinion, is pretty broken, because it literally allows you to do, to get tips infinitely, potentially. So one of the mechanics with the customers is that they don't actually get out of the cab as long as you're close enough to the location, and not inside the location. So if I were to sit here and let this guy run down the clock as I get slammed by these two cars over and over again, this guy is never going to get out of my cab, even though I'm not at the destination yet, but I'm close enough to it. So because of this, you could utilize the back drift. I know it's kind of confusing because the other skill I went over is also called the back drift. But again, I'm not even sure if that's the right word for it anyways. With the back drift, basically what you do, and I've tried to do this plenty of times, but there's no tutorials anywhere that I could find that actually tell you how to do it. You basically just go backwards in a certain way that, like, tricks the cab into thinking you're doing, like, drifts. And you just constantly, you're just going around in a little circle over and over again, and you're earning combos that whole time. You're getting tips, so you can, as long as you're close enough to a location, obviously this isn't really going to work at every location anyways, but certain ones where there's enough space to do it, no traffic that's going to get in the way, you could just get infinite tips. Which, in arcade, to be fair, isn't actually going to be that useful, since it requires setup and it's going to take up a lot of time to get a huge thing anyways. But in the time modes, that's when backdrifts really shine a lot, like the 5 minutes and 10 minutes time, where you can just spend the entirety of the 10 minutes going around in circles. You can really do that in arcade, since you only start with a maximum of 70 seconds. But as you can see here, customers don't get out of the cab as long as you're close enough to the destination, which is a good thing to know in and of itself. You can see here about how far away you have to be until they get out. Actually got a good deal of leeway there. So it's good to know in case you're, like, really coming down with a customer that's about to run out of time. As long as you're close enough there, and they, before they run out of time, you're still good to actually get them to where they need to go. There's one more thing I want to go over before we go over the map itself, and that is customer manipulation. So let's go down here. Let me go over what customer manipulation is, because I'm going to be utilizing this at various locations here on the map in order to demonstrate a few things. So right in front of me here is a green customer. This customer is pretty rare to be green. I think a lot of times she's orange or she's not even active at all. So it's good to get her while she's green, obviously. You make more money and she takes you farther. Now what you can do with characters on the map, say you have a certain character that you want to be, or a certain customer that you want to be a certain color, you can easily just drive far away enough, doesn't have to be that far, but far away enough to deload them. Oh, I don't know if I didn't drive away far enough there. I probably didn't. Let's see. Whoa, what the heck's going on? That was weird. Okay, so now they're completely deloaded. Just to show you. Oh, no, they still didn't do it. I could just be getting unlucky here. You don't have to drive away that far, but for some reason this one's being a little stingy and not changing on me. You're ruining my example here. Why is she not changing colors? Okay, I swear this works. It's just not working now. I'm definitely driving away far enough. There we go, okay. That is customer manipulation. Obviously it takes time to do this, so you don't want to do it all the time, but when you're kind of coming down to the wire and you don't have that many options, or you really, really want to go to a certain location on the map or a certain direction around the map, then it might be advantageous to actually waste a little bit of time by driving. Like, say I come up to this customer and she's orange, just like she was green a second ago. All I have to do is drive, you know, a little bit farther away, waste maybe 10 seconds or so, come back, and now she's green again, and we can get her. That is customer manipulation. I'm going to be doing that at some of the locations that I'm going to go over in a little bit here, so that I can get, you know, favorable odds while I show off certain customers, which is going to be what I'm going to be doing next. I don't know why I went all the way back here. So that's all of the skills and a few other little mechanics that you should be aware of while playing Crazy Taxi. Now we're going to go over customers and the arcade map itself, which really comes down to the customers. So this is going to be how to properly play the arcade map. Now the arcade map, as opposed to the original map, is arranged basically in a big circle. And the best and most efficient way to play it is to continuously do loops around the circle. You want to kind of avoid turning around and going backwards around the circle as much as you can. Obviously, forwards is the way you're facing when you start the game. You want to continue doing loops around the map as many times as you can. Eventually, you know, obviously you can't do that for the entirety of the game. Eventually, you're going to have to backtrack, I guess, once you kind of are done doing loops to get customers. Because most customers in the game, or in certain areas of the game, every customer is going to make you go forward. So you're going to have to pick up customers and then go back, like take that customer to its destination, and then go back and get more, like a bunch of oranges and yellows, really, mostly, to backtrack to get them. But for the beginning of the game, in order to gain time and a lot of money as well efficiently, you want to do loops around the map. And for the most part here in the starting areas, it's pretty easy to do loops. There's a lot of greens over here. I would say it's best to get greens first for like the beginning of the game, because they're going to take you farther. Like typically I would get these guys over here, but pretty much everybody in like this starting area is going to send you forward anyways. But I would usually get one of these four customers are usually the four that I get first. They can be green, like light green there, or yellow. So I'll definitely go for whatever ones are light green, as opposed to the yellows. And they're going to send you forward. There's a couple more greens up here. There's one there. And there's one over there. I think that's it. No, there's another one there. There's three light greens up here. Good to know. Like I said, you want to get the greens first. But I would value these greens down here. Now there's three tiers or three hills here. One on my left, one on my right, and this one here in the middle. And on each of these hilly streets, there's three tiers to them. On each tier, here's like the first one and the second one here. On each tier of each of these three streets that go down the hill, there is a green customer. So it's good to know. I like to get these guys before, like kind of the guys here at the top of the hill. Just because they're a bit harder to get, a bit more annoying to get, like later in the game. And some of them actually send you pretty far too, like these customers here. I'll kind of demonstrate, make a save state. She goes all the way to Popcorn Mania, which is pretty far. And I think this guy down here also goes pretty far. Yeah, Tower Records, which is really far. Compared to some of these other greens, which typically, a lot of these guys typically go to the park area, the square park, or one of the locations around there. So yeah, one, two, and obviously a third one down here. I kind of like these light greens here, or this one in particular, because she goes to Pizza Hut, which is really nice since it's kind of close to like the beach area. It doesn't really go as far away as the other greens do. So getting her kind of allows you to turn around and get a different green sort of from the beach, which we're going to see in a minute here. There is an extra green on this side, the right side, while going down here. And this is another customer that takes you really far. She takes you all the way to KFC. So it's good to know those ones specifically, the ones that go to like KFC and Tower Records, because they take you all the way past like the park. And yeah, sometimes you just want to skip over that area since there's not really that many good customers to get there, and you could just get them later, I guess. And they kind of skip over this entire area as well, but most of the greens will pass like the beach and all this area up here anyways. I think there is another customer on this side that'll go to Pizza Hut, if I'm not mistaken. There's a light green here. Where does he go? Square Park. All the other greens, I believe, go to like Fila or Popcorn Mania or something like that. I think this one goes to Pizza Hut, right? Oh, she goes to KFC too. Never mind, I stand corrected. I don't know anything about this game. Why am I making a tutorial? This guy. You go to Pizza Hut, right? Fila! Okay, I swear when I did this the other day, one of them went to Pizza Hut, but honestly, knowing the specific, like, where they go specifically isn't really that important. It's more about knowing, like, which customers to get. I mean, obviously you could potentially just route out every single customer on the map, but I don't think that's really necessary for most people. Here's this lady again. She can be green sometimes. Best to get her while she's green. A couple of these other guys here, I'm not really going to go over each one specifically, but some of these other guys here on the side, you'll see as you play this guy here, for example, or this gal. And I think that guy too can also be light green, so a lot of these kind of dudes off to the side here can be light green. Just drive backwards again, maybe some of them changed. Oh, they all changed for the worse, except for her. So it's good to note some of those other guys can also be light green. And there's a couple of yellows over here. I like to save them for later and get the greens in the water here first. Just get them out of the way since they take you pretty far. Obviously, you can't really backtrack to get greens since it'll take way too much time. Whereas the yellows over there, I think they only take you to Pizza Hut, the ones in the water. So that's not very far, so you can easily just turn around from Pizza Hut up ahead here and get like more people from the beach. So let's go on to, I guess, the park. There's not really too many other customers around here to talk about. There's another light green here as well. This guy, this, whatever his name is, my favorite character in the game, or my favorite customer in the game, the guy with the Liberty Spikes there. He's also light green when he's active, but he's not. This guy's also light green, but not right now. He's yellow. Or he can be light green, obviously. So it's good to know. It's good to know where all the greens are, and which ones are like good to get. All the greens in this area are good to get. They're all gonna take you forward. So now we're in the park. A couple of noteworthy customers over here are the reverends. There's three of them. There's that yellow over there. You can see all the reverends look the same. There's this one, and there's another one over here that's also not active. It's good to know about these customers because they'll take you past KFC and Tower Records and the Levi's and straight to the field. So when you're trying to go to the field, you can get one of these guys and just pass that other area up, because you'll find pretty quickly that like Levi's, Tower Records, and KFC area really becomes a dead spot. So whenever you get, like later in the game, whenever you get a customer that takes you there, you kind of have to either go to the field or drive all the way like back here or drive backwards to get somebody and just waste time. So like once that area kind of runs out, getting one of these reverends can just kind of skip you past that area and save you a little bit of time, you know. A couple other noteworthy customers in this area. There's a couple of greens here. This is actually one of them right here. Right now he's orange. Let me drive to the other side of the park here because there's another green over here. This one's actually active and green. So it's good to know these guys are here. These are usually the first guys I get in the park if I can. Okay, there we go. Now he's the right color. He's solid green. The other guy is light green. I actually don't know where they go off the top of my head, so let me see. He goes to the heliport, which is really good. So you get to skip pretty much the whole field there. Go straight to the top. This guy has changed colors, but I'm pretty sure he goes to... Actually, where does he go? That guy goes to the heliport. Where does this guy go when he's light green? Let's find out. It's useful information, but he also goes to the heliport. I guess he's just close enough to be a different color, but still be the same location. Even though they don't really look like they're... He doesn't really look like he's any closer, so that's kind of odd. That's everybody noteworthy over here. These guys over here, I guess, are kind of noteworthy since they're, like, options. Usually some of the first people I get as well once I run out of customers in the KFC, Tower Records, Levi's area. I'll come back and get these guys since they're pretty close. There's a reverend here. They'll take you to the church. All the reverends go to the church all the time. So now if you go up here, there is a very useful customer. And this is... the police station lady. She always goes to the police station. This lady here is pretty important. She is always here whenever you need her, and she always goes to the police station. She's always solid green. You don't have to worry about coming up here and she's like red or something. And she's noteworthy because she's the first customer we're going to see here that takes you over the freeway. Now, the freeway is a big, long strip of road. That's what freeways are. that's a big dead area. There's no customers there, so you'd never really want to. There's never any. If you're going over the freeway without any customers, you're playing the game wrong. So having customers that will take you over the freeway is really key to playing a really long game. Like, once you run out of customers that'll take you over the freeway, your game's pretty much over. Because then you can't really. It takes way too much time to go over there without a customer. So that's how you kind of have, how you have to plan the game, is knowing how many trips you have over the freeway left. That's how I like to think about it. And this is the first customer that we've seen that'll take you, actually take you over the freeway. Good to know. I tend to save her for later, or like usually last sometimes even, because she's always there. Whereas some of the other ones we'll see up ahead can be unreliable as far as going over the freeway. There's a few greens up here that we'll see that can take you over the freeway, but might not. So sometimes your games can vary. How many trips you have over the freeway can actually vary by a few trips as well. There are a few noteworthy customers here. There's this lady who's not active right now, but she's good to get while she's yellow. And I'll show you. Maybe I can get her to change here. There's a reverend here, and this red guy. I think you can be a different color too. Wow, that's really rare. But a good example is these two greens. Both these guys are good to get. I'm pretty sure. Let's see where he goes. Obviously, this guy, more often than not, will go to the baseball stadium. But there's a couple versions of this guy that won't go to the baseball stadium if they're a certain color. So both these guys go to baseball stadium. Very good, because the field up ahead we're gonna see is a good place you. To skip going through without customers, because most of the customers, or a lot of the customers in the field, can turn you around and send you back to this area that we're at right now, and you really don't want that. So taking like one of these greens will just take you all the way past that, all the way past RB station, straight to the baseball stadium, which is really, really good, obviously, because there's a lot of customers at the baseball stadium that'll then take you over the freeway, and you can continue doing your loop from there on out. So it's good to know about them. Let me go over here real quick. This guy here, he's red right now, but he can also be light green. And this yellow right here can also be light green as well. Let me see if I could change them real quick. I don't think they're going to change while going this far away, but maybe they will. Okay, now he's light green. The other guy's still red, but you can take my word for it that he can be light green. I think this guy goes to. Oh, he also goes to baseball stadium. Never mind. I don't know where that guy goes. Let me go down here. I tend to get. Okay, now she's yellow, so let me see where she goes just to demonstrate. She goes to heliport. Again, heliport's a good location because it takes you all the way to the top of the hill. Get to skip driving through the hill, through the grassy, hilly area. And from heliport, you can very easily get to baseball stadium or RB station, either just by driving there or by picking up a couple of the customers, like the Reds that are in that area, that'll take you to one of those locations. And at RB station, baseball stadium, there's a lot of customers to get that will send you in the right direction. I tend to get one of the. If I see one of these greens here, I tend to get them first because these guys are never active when you need them. So it's good to get them while you can. Same thing with this guy and this guy, you know. Get them as soon as you can whenever you're in this area because a lot of RNG involved there. A couple of other noteworthy customers here. Well, first off, there's two Reds here. That one and that one are both Reverends and they both go to the church. So if none of the Greens are here, I might get one of them. This customer here can be a little tricky because she's one of the only customers in this area that can actually send you backwards. Let's see where she wants to go. Heliport. She either goes to Heliport or I think Fila, which actually kind of reminds me. There's a customer I forgot to go over. Let me go back real quick. Okay, so now we're back over here. One thing I forgot to mention was this lady. She goes to Pizza Hut. It doesn't really seem like it's that important to know that, but it can be useful when you're backtracking and trying to get all of the yellows and stuff. If you get somebody from the beach or something that sends you all the way to Fila, which there are a couple people that do that. You can get this lady and take yourself back to Pizza Hut, and then from Pizza Hut you can get back go back to the beach. You know, it's just a little bit better if you can, you know, have a customer at any time that'll take you in the direction you want to go. You know, it's better to have a customer, I guess, is what I'm trying to say, than to not have a customer than just to drive there. So when you're trying to backtrack and work backwards, it's good to know which customers actually can send you backwards. So this one can send you backwards. I think she's always orange, so there's not really any way to tell where she's going to go. So be cautious when picking her up. But this guy over here is pretty good because he always goes to heliport, I believe. Or RB station. I always get it mixed up. Always goes to RB station. So he's really reliable. One of those customers you're going to get pretty early on in this area. Around here, there's another baseball stadium guy, so also really good. Sometimes he's orange, though. Don't even bother picking him up if he's orange. Just a waste. And there's another baseball stadium guy right here. Obviously, he's not active right now, but you can take my word for it. When he's light green, he will take you to the baseball stadium. This guy here also goes to RB station. A lot of these guys in the field, I'm not really sure if they always go there. I feel like this guy does go somewhere else sometimes. But some of these other ones, or most of the other people in the field here, actually will turn you around, which you don't want. Obviously, you can see that guy went to heliport, that guy went to Tower Records. All these yellows. Oh, he goes to baseball stadium. Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. I guess it's just risky, is probably a better way to put it. I tend to just skip these guys. When I'm doing my loops earlier in the game, I tend to skip as many people in here as I can, because a lot of them can send you backwards, and going back to the Tower Records area is really just a waste of time. And these guys are honestly pretty easy to get through backtracking at the end of the game anyways, and just kind of collecting them all, going back and forth. You don't really want to do that stuff earlier in the game. The light greens here are deceiving. All of them go backwards, so don't ever get them unless you're trying to go backwards and trying to just get everybody else at the park, because I think these two light greens will actually send you all the way back to like the square park area. Some of these guys at the top of the hill are actually safe to get. Like some of them will go and make another safe state here. Some of them will go to like the baseball stadium, and some of them will go to like back down. See, you see a lot of them go to like Tower Records and stuff. Baseball stadium. So they're just risky, really, is my whole point here with the field. He goes to RB station. So I really only start picking up these guys when I have nobody else to pick up, or when I'm prepared to actually, you know, turn around, when I don't mind turning around. And here's another customer. He's the second customer that we're going to see now that can go backwards. Or that's not right. He's the second customer that we've seen now that can go over the freeway. But he only goes over the freeway when he's solid green, so you don't really want to pick him up any other time, because when he's solid green, he's a guaranteed trip over the freeway. And any guarantee that you have to go over the freeway, you want to use to go over the freeway when possible. So sometimes he's like light green. Don't be deceived when he's light green, because he'll take you back around the other way. I think he's also orange sometimes, and that's just a complete waste of time. Kind of worth noting too, there's this red guy up over here that takes you to the baseball stadium. And then, so here we are at RB station. RB station is a little iffy sometimes, because some of these guys can send you backwards. So more often than not, they'll go over the freeway. And I wish I knew exactly which ones will send you backwards and which ones don't. Let me just kind of pick some of them up. She goes to CT Hospital. We'll see if any of them actually will go backwards. I'm not sure. He goes to the bank. Clock Tower Theater. I think this guy probably will go backwards since he's light green. I don't think he's going to have enough. He's too far away to go over the freeway. Yeah, he goes back to Levi's, which is terrible. Again, never really want to get sent back to that area. But, yeah, the ones in the middle tend to be a little iffy. Even if they're solid green, sometimes they go back to, like, Popcorn Mania or Fila, which really sucks. But you do have, potentially, over here, you've got those two greens there, these three customers, there's a pregnant lady there that's not active, and over here you have this lady, there's a reverend here, obviously he goes to the church. This lady is also solid green, or can be solid green, and she goes over the freeway when she does as well. So you do have, potentially, six trips over the freeway here. Obviously, you don't want to pick up any of these guys when they're not solid green, especially this lady here, because it's a waste of a trip over the freeway, and you want to have as many trips over the freeway as you possibly can. So that's the RB station. Just know those guys in the middle. I think one of those guys from the direction I'm facing now Just reload the save state. I think one of these guys here also can go backwards, but not 100% sure. It's just something you gotta... It's really just RNG anyways, and something you gotta deal with while playing. Look at these billboards. I've never really taken any time to actually look at these before. Take off your stress. Alright. So, let's move on to the baseball stadium. Baseball stadium is a lot better than RB Station since it's a lot more reliable with its customers. Everybody here that's green goes over the freeway, which is nice. There's three customers here. This guy here on my left, the pregnant lady here that's not active, and this guy right here. All three of them, when they're green, I think they can only be green, go over the freeway, which is good. Trips over the freeway are always good. The only problem with these three specifically is that they're not always active. Usually it's just one of them at a time. But if you really wanted to, you could probably manipulate them pretty easily by driving, like, over here, maybe. This might be far away enough. Let's see if they change. And they did. No, no, they didn't. Never mind. Well, we saw that customer manipulation's pretty easy. You don't have to drive that far away. If you boost and, like, drift and stuff, it doesn't take that long. So usually at the baseball stadium, I'll get one of them first, since they're kind of annoying, since they can be inactive or active. And then I'll usually get this lady, because she was light green before, but now she's yellow. When she's light green, she goes over the freeway. Reload my save state. Over here, there's a few customers. There's this lady right in front of me in the white. She is not active. There's that guy, or that lady. There's this guy right here. There should be one more, I thought. Let me go back a little... A little farther back here, see if I can change their direction. Like I said before, everybody over here that's solid green or light green will go over the freeway. These guys I tend to save until later, because some of them can be yellow. There's a couple over here that I think are always yellow, but whenever I see a light green over here, I'll get them. That way I can try to avoid having to deal with, you know, manipulating them or having coming over here and only having like yellows to pick up. So whenever I see a green over there, I'll get them. There we go. Now you can see. Oh, here's the other customer I was looking for. I'm pretty sure this one and this lady. It's good because all four of them are active here. I'm going to run out of time, so I'll pause it. So this lady that's behind me here and the lady directly in front of me in the white, they're always yellow or red, I guess. One of them was red a second ago. But the point is they never are green, so they never go over the freeway. But those two back there behind do go over the freeway while they're light green. And then the last two customers I want to show off are these two over here. These two are great because they're always here. They always go over the freeway, like everybody else at the baseball stadium. But yeah, they're always here. So everybody else you can see at the baseball stadium, while the customers are reliable, you know, it's easy to tell which ones are going to go over the freeway and which ones are not. They can be turned off or they can be, you know, different colors a couple times in a couple examples. But these two are always here, and because of that, it's good to kind of save them for last if you can. Like, if there's nobody else at the baseball stadium to pick up for some reason, and you don't really want to waste the time to manipulate, try to manipulate the customers, which usually you don't want to do if you can avoid, you can just come get one of these because they're always here. So it's good to know that you always have these two reliable trips over the freeway as well. So I think right now I'm just going to actually restart and come back to this area with more time so I can actually show off the rest of the map on the other side of the freeway. Okay, so now that I'm here with more time, I can properly show this off. So this is the freeway. A good way to get over the freeway without really thinking about it is to hug the wall here on the left when you get on, and then when you get to this part, shift over to the right, and you can just keep boosting this whole time and not even look at the screen. I just close my eyes and easily just traverse the freeway. Usually you won't run into cars, but sometimes you still will, like, clip one of those trucks. But more often than not, you can get through the freeway without even thinking about it pretty quickly as well. I think it is still technically faster and better for combos, too, to, if you can avoid hitting stuff, that is, to drive, like, in between the cars and boost that way instead of hugging on the wall. But it's good to know you can do that. So over here is the downtown area. This area of the map becomes a bit more complicated because this is where the kind of, in my opinion, the more arcadiness of this game really shows, like the aspects of the game that really are meant to end your game, I guess. Because this whole area is kind of a death trap if you don't know which customers to get. Everything we've seen up until this point, with a few exceptions, pretty much sends you forward. So it's really easy if you don't know what you're doing to go over the freeway. But if you don't know what you're doing and get to this area, it's really easy to kind of get stuck in this area. Or get stuck going back. You can go back over the freeway as well pretty easily here. Which is really the biggest problem I used to have when I was playing arcade before I knew actually how to play the map. First things first, there's a couple of customers here. It's good. There's one here. This area is basically laid out like two diamonds. I think I'm gonna have a map down in the description, a link to a map, so you can take a look at the arcade map and you can see what I'm talking about. It was two diamonds with two kind of middle areas in between them. So at the entrance of the middle areas here, at this first like half by the freeway exit, there's one light green here, and there's another light green all the way over here, this one. They're both at the same locations on opposite like sides. Obviously, right now she's orange, but it's good to know that they're there because they send you far away enough. Like, let me see if this other one's still green. She is. I'm pretty sure they go to the bus terminal. Yeah, they do. Which is good because it sends you forward pretty far into the loop, so it's good to get them. A lot of the customers here aren't going to send you very far, like the oranges and stuff. And like I said, it's easy to get stuck in this area if you're just getting a lot of oranges. Over here in the middle, there is a lot of greens. Doesn't really look that way right now since a lot of them are red. But the thing is with these guys is you have to know which ones are safe. But there's an easy way to do that. So there's four streets here, four little road islands in the middle of them. And all six of these customers, there's two customers on each of these islands, all six of them can be green. Now, the ones here on this side in front of the hospital, no matter what, those guys, while they're green, will send you back over the freeway. A quick note is sometimes that actually can be advantageous. It really just depends on how your game has been going, like kind of the state of your game. If you somehow end up with an extra trip over the freeway, but you've kind of killed some of the later parts of the map, like in the downtown area, like you don't really have too many good customers over there. Sometimes you might actually want to go back over the freeway, the other direction. That's not really my play style. Like, I don't think that's very good. Most of the time, I try to use all those trips as I can. But there are definitely sometimes, depending on the state of the game, you actually might want to do that. But these guys here in front of the hospital, no matter what, they always go over the freeway while they're green. So try to avoid them unless you want to go over the freeway again, or backwards over the freeway. Now, for all the other six customers, the same rule applies for all of them. The one in the front, I guess in the middle here, can go forward while they're solid green, but they only go forward while both customers on their respective islands are solid green. So we can see this lady here. The one behind her is solid green, so she's going to go forward to Lookout Tower. And you can see this guy here, he's solid green, but the person behind him is red, so he's going to go to baseball stadium. It's definitely more advantageous to use these guys to go forward than it is to go backwards. So, like I said, the same rule applies to all three of them. As long as both customers on the islands are solid green, the one in the middle, towards the middle, will go forward, except for the two in front of the hospital. I guess what you can really do, if you really need someone to go forward, is pretty easily manipulate these guys by just kind of leaving this area. Now we've changed these two to solid green, so now she's gonna go to Lookout Tower. And over here, that one's still red, so this guy is still gonna go to baseball stadium, I guess. But she's still solid green, or both, they're both still solid green, so the one in front still goes to Lookout Tower. So that's really useful to know, 'cause it's if you don't know what you're doing and you come into this area, you're probably just gonna like, you know, pick up, ooh, you know, see a green customer and be like, ooh, a green, you know, just get these greens, make a lot of money, but you gotta know which ones are the good ones to get and when to get them so you can keep doing loops around the map. Because otherwise, you'll just get all these greens and potentially just go backwards. Because even if you go to Lookout Tower, for example, you're probably still gonna end up going backwards if you don't know what you're doing. But you could easily just keep going back and forth over the freeway by getting these greens and those greens, and then you're out of greens over here, and then your whole game's ruined. It's dead at that point. So I guess one more thing to note about these customers specifically is when I play, I try to avoid getting the outside customer, I guess, not the one in the middle, until I get this one. Because obviously, if I pick up, say, if I picked up the other green over there first, then I lose my way of actually telling when it's safe to pick up, or at least determining where the one in the middle is actually going to go. So always avoid trying to getting that one in the back first, and go for the ones in the middle here first. There's one more notable customer over here. That is, if we go in front of the Clock Tower Theaters and go up here, there's this guy who always goes to the fire station, and he's always here, so he's a very reliable way to get past this area and to continue your loop, since he's always here and he's, you know, easy to get. And because of that, I usually save him. I try to save him, but sometimes, look at this, you can go up here. Getting kind of sidetracked, but where does this go? Going on an adventure now. It didn't go anywhere. Go figures. So yeah, that's that. The fire station guy up there, and you have these three greens in the middle that can go forward, but only if both of them are green. Any other greens in this area, like these ones here off to the side, they never go forward. They only go back over the freeway. So kind of try to avoid getting them. I think some of these guys over here can also be green. Not sure about that, but doesn't matter, because nobody else that I haven't gone over will go forward over the around the loop that you want to go. So now it brings me to this opposite side. I'm gonna reload my save state so I have a little bit more time. So now we're on the opposite side of where the freeway exit was, and there's four more greens over here. So there's one. There's this guy right behind me, and luckily he's already green, so I don't have to like change him or anything. There's him. There's this one right here. There's one more. Oh, there's this one right here. And then this one, who's orange right now, but you could take my word for it. Sometimes he's light green. See if I can manipulate him, just for the sake of showing it off. I did not. Oh well. He can be light green as well. So you want to avoid picking any of these guys up when they're not light green, since it's kind of a waste of a far trip around the loop. So these guys here, an easy way to remember these ones is the two like on the outside of the exits, just like how it is in the front, where the freeway exit is. It's the two customers on the outside of the exits, or entrances, I guess, from the middle area of this area. Maybe that wasn't the best way to describe that, but hope that makes sense. And then, as you can see, a couple of these guys can be solid green, but while they're solid green, they actually go backwards over the freeway. So unless you want to go backwards over the freeway for some reason, do not get them while they're solid green. Mostly these two on the outside, whereas the other two are either orange or light green. So those four you want to get while they're light green. Now, over here in the mall, there's a couple of customers. I think they're pretty easy to miss a lot of the time. There's these two. Obviously, the first one there, she's, I think, always orange. But the one behind her, let's see if I can change her around. That red behind her can be light green. I'll see if I can show that off here. Don't know if I went far away enough. I'll just go extra far away just to be safe. There we go. So she changed to light green, which is good. So now she goes to Lookout Tower, I believe. So that's an extra trip to Lookout Tower, which is really nice. And then on the other side of the mall, I'll just drive through the mall, there is another lady And I'm not going to manipulate her, but you can take my word for it that the two, this lady here that's also farther in the mall, can also be light green, also goes to the lookout tower. But right now she's yellow, so you want to try to get them while they're light green as well. Just remember it's the two customers that are farther in the mall at both of the entrances that can be light green. So let me go back here and try and change the customers around a bit so I can show off these other guys. A couple more of really good customers. They're good because they're reliable. This yellow guy here, make another save state, he always goes to Lookout Tower. He's just not always active. That's the only problem with him. And then over here, no, he's not act the customer I'm looking for is not active, so let me see if I can manipulate real quick. There we go. This light green too, also pretty good since he always goes, I think, to Fire Station. So those two are good because they're reliable, just not always active. A lot of these oranges over here, they can actually go to the bus terminal, but they don't always do that, so you can't really rely on them going to bus terminal. I think the one exception is this guy here, but I think even this guy can go backwards sometimes. Yeah, see, he goes to the bank. But generally speaking, these guys here in the middle area of this second kind of square or diamond all go forward. This light green lady, this yellow guy, I think he can also be light green. And this guy right here who's not active, there's three of them. They always go forward, so they're pretty good to get when you need to go forward, which is all the time. And then this guy always goes to the tennis courts. He's good to get, or he's good to kind of save. I like to save him too, usually, because he's one of those customers that's just always there. One of the kind of, I guess, hidden customers. He's not really that hidden. Not much more to say about these other guys. Some of these yellows can go forward. Sometimes they can go back. I like getting this lady. She seems to be the most reliable of them. Except right now, of course. But same thing with these guys. Sometimes those yellows will go to Lookout Tower. But sometimes they don't. And a lot of the oranges over here also sometimes go to Bus Terminal. But sometimes they don't. Let me see if any of them will actually go to Bus Terminal. Nope. What about that other orange? Maybe he'll go to Bus Terminal. He actually did, but kind of got to get these guys at your own risk. Bus terminal can be a really annoying location sometimes because you could just get games where, like, nobody wants to go to bus terminal. There's a yellow over here. It's kind of easy to miss since he's not always active, and there's another yellow guy right here too. Again, those guys can go forward, but they can also go backwards. A quick note about this little road here, this pass, I guess, is it's generally better to go on the left side. It's a bit more clear, pretty easy to go through, as you can see there. I have my traffic on like the middle setting, so it might be different if you have your traffic on a higher setting. You do want to avoid going down below, though, to the through that underpass or whatever. So the bus terminal is probably the worst location in the game, and I say that because almost everybody here wants to go backwards, so it's just really bad for that. And the customers that do go forward are pretty RNG like dependent as well. So it's just a terrible place for the most part. So you got these three customers here. I believe this lady, while she's orange, typically does go to Fire Station, except for right now. So you can see what I mean. Okay, so that guy goes to Fire Station. I think it's just those two. I don't think this lady, the yellow one, goes to Fire Station, which she might. It's one of those things I don't really know exactly, but you do know, you should be aware that those two oranges there in front of these kind of three right here, those two can go to Fire Station. Obviously, it's kind of dependent. I think you can actually learn the patterns of this place if you look at all the customers and see which ones are which colors. You can kind of tell where they want to go, but that's a lot of work. The reds, however, I like getting the reds here because the reds always go to Lookout Tower, and there's more reds at Lookout Tower you can get that always come back here, so you can kind of go back and forth and get all the reds. It's not really, strictly speaking, the best money-making venture because reds don't really give you a lot of money, but getting these customers, especially here at the bus terminal more specifically than the lookout tower, can be a hassle. So getting them is better than not getting them at all. So you can do that as a strategy if you really want to. But yeah, something to think about. So let's go over here to my least favorite customers of the game. And I say that because these guys are just complete RNG, with a small exception. All three of them can go forward while they're light green. But there's really no conclusive way to tell when they're going to go forward. There is kind of a method where if you take these three customers over here, depending on which one of these three is yellow, you're supposed to be able to tell which one of these guys. I think it's either clockwise or counterclockwise, I can't remember. But I've done it in testing and it's not 100%, so I never even bother with that. I just pick these guys up at my own risk, you know, accept my fate. Whatever happens, happens. If they go backwards, then I just deal with it and keep playing the game. That's one of the great things about Crazy Taxi is you really do have to, in a lot of ways, make it up as you go along with the elements of RNG, and every game is going to be like slightly different, you know? You gotta like alter your strategy and alter your game plan as you play sometimes. And that's great. So all three of these guys can go forward when they're light green. Let's actually make a save state here. Let's see where they go. To the bank. I think they all go to tennis courts when they're light green. But this is obviously terrible. All of them go backwards. Literally all three go to the bank. So that's really bad RNG. Let me see if I can actually manipulate these guys real quick because one of them can actually be a different color. See if I got it to change. I did not, but I wonder if these guys actually changed their locations. They did. They went to tennis courts. So that guy over there in the purple, he can actually be yellow. And when he's solid yellow, he does go forward. So I get him, if I ever see him when he's yellow, I get him right away because that eliminates one third of the kind of RNG nightmare that these three customers can be. So, on to Lookout Tower. All of the reds here, or most of the reds here, I should say, let's make another save state, go to bus terminal. A couple of them will go to fire station, so that's good to know. I believe it might be this guy that goes to fire station. Let me see. Yeah, he does. This guy over here goes to fire station. God, that's so annoying. Wait up, pick me up, wait up, pick me up. And this guy also goes to fire station when he's red. So it's good to know that you go forward. I'm gonna actually reset these customers here. This guy. So the general rule for Lookout Tower is yellows are typically what you want, but you need to know which yellows to get. Obviously, this guy was yellow, but he went backwards to the hotel. So there's two customers right here. Okay. Physics are gonna intervene. Both of these customers right in front of me can be light green and they can be yellow. I don't know if they can be any other colors, but it doesn't matter. You want to get them while they're yellow because they go to tennis courts while they're yellow. Directly behind me, this lady, I'm gonna go change them real quick. But that lady right there, when she's yellow, she also goes to tennis courts, so pretty useful to know. Let me see if she changed. She did. Make another save state. Also goes to tennis courts. Did that other customer change by chance? No, she didn't. But take my word for it, those two, when they're yellow, they go to tennis courts. There's another yellow over here. This lady directly in front of me that's currently red, when she's yellow, she does not go to tennis courts. She's one of the ones that's not safe to get. But this guy over here, he's kind of an asshole. Well, I guess she goes to fire station too. Which is kind of good to know, I guess. But not really that important. Like I said, reds. Going back to the bus terminal, it's not really that bad of a thing. This guy right here is kind of a dick because sometimes he goes to tennis courts when he's yellow, and other times he goes back to like the hotel or the mall, I guess. So yeah, but he can go to tennis courts. But those three are always safe while they're yellow. Her and those two light greens over there, but only while they're yellow. And this guy can be safe, can go forward. So now we're going on to the fire station, and we've got kind of a bad spread of customers here. Generally speaking, oranges more often than not here will go to the tennis courts. Let me see. I'll try to prove that here. But it's not 100%, obviously. He goes to bus terminal. Worst come to worst, you can drive from bus terminal back to this area or the lookout tower if you really want to. They're not that far away. And sometimes I would advise that rather than going backwards or risk going backwards. Light greens over here tend to go to the university, but obviously sometimes they don't. You can see there. So it's a little bit of RNG. Let's see if I can manipulate the customers here, change them around to give you another example. I did not want this guy. God damn it. Okay, so now these guys changed. So this guy right here, he always goes forward when he's light green. So he's usually one of the first ones I get. Everybody else, you kind of got to take a chance with. But just know that oranges can go to the tennis courts and the light greens can go to university. So let's just reload here. That's really all I have to say about Fire Station. There's probably, again, probably a way you can tell more definitively if you know the patterns. I just don't know that. I just kind of wing it. And it's worked pretty well for me so far. This area, though, you don't have to wing it. So there's two hills here, two tiers of hill on. It's kind of like the starting area, but with one less tier of hill. So there's only two actual hills going up. And each one has two customers on it. Any customer on the two outside hills, not the middle, we'll get to the middle, but any customer on the two outside hills, or the two outside streets on the hill, while they are light green, always go forward. Any of the light greens here, so like this one, will always go forward. Save state real quick. This guy, he might go forward, let's see. Now he goes to the bank. So light greens here always go forward. Let's go up to the next level and we'll see if there's any light greens up here. There's no light greens. But all of the solid greens can also go forward. But they're not guaranteed to go forward. So typically what I'll do on these hills, on the sides at least, is get the light greens first or try to manipulate a light green. Usually when I go up, one of the four will be light green. And it's kind of RNG, once you kind of get less and less. Well, actually, I say one of the four, but this customer here, and it's same for the other side. Both sides of the hill are exactly the same. The customers obviously just on opposite sides, but they have the same rules. Whereas this one here, that's the first one on the upper hill, coming from the bottom, I guess. She is, and the one on the other side are always solid green, and it's RNG. Where they want to go, I guess. There's no way to tell with the other ones. Like, you can only pick up those other ones when they're light green. But like I said, all of them, I'm pretty sure. I'm actually not 100% sure about the one down here. I think the one at the very bottom, is the sole exception. But the other three all can go forward when they're solid green. So you can, if you don't have the time to waste to try and manipulate one of them to be light green, you can just pick up the solid green and just keep your fingers crossed that they're going to go forward. So you could do more loops around the hill, but you just take my word for it. Light greens are what you want to get on the sides if you can. You can always take your chances with a solid green though if you really want, or manipulate them. Over here, this is really good. Both of them are solid or light green. See, they go to university. I just want to demonstrate this side is exactly the same. There's two down there. Both of them can be light green. This one right here is always solid green, and the one up there can be solid green or light green. But like I said, you can see there, solid green. She did go forward. But that's just all RNG, unfortunately. Maybe there's a way to tell. I'm not sure if the color of the other customer on the hill actually affects it. I've tested it a little bit. Sometimes it seems pretty reliable that they will go forward when the other one's also light green, but like the other customer on the same hill is light green, but I haven't really been able to determine that. Like definitively. But that one customer in the middle, though, is generally pretty safe. Like, if all four of them are solid green, I would get that one that is always green first. Because I believe they have three different locations they can go to, and I don't remember what they are. Obviously, one of them is like Sales Street or Fresh Tree Street. But two of them are going forward, so you do have decent odds with that one. Whereas when the other ones, I'm pretty sure, are 50-50. I don't know if that's exactly how it works, but you know what I mean. So here we are in this area. Make another save state here. This lady, this is the middle hill. This lady is the sole exception to this entire area of light greens going forward. She's the only one that can go backwards when she's light green. And this guy here, I believe, always goes backwards while he's solid green. But he's good to get while he's light green. Up here, there's two yellows. And these guys always go forward when they're yellow. Let me just show that off here. They always go to university. So they're pretty solid. I usually get those guys last and just kind of play around with the RNG and the manipulation of the other guys first, because that takes up time. And those guys, these yellows here, can actually be inactive, which is annoying, but while they're there, they always go forward. And this guy's good to get while he's light green. It's just this lady that's kind of RNG, unfortunately. So just keep that in mind, that she is the sole exception to this whole area, in that she can go backwards while she's light green. Everybody else is generally safe. Another example here of how these customers can change. Now one's orange and one is not even active, so don't want to get these guys while they're anything but yellow. So now let's go up to the tennis courts. So tennis courts, you want to get oranges first. Yellows and light greens, I'll demonstrate here, will always go backwards, so you don't really want to get them. Like, they go lookout tower all the way back to bus terminal. That's terrible. While oranges, some of them actually go to fire station. That's really not so bad, since it's a really quick trip and it's really close to a lot of other good customers to get. So that's not too bad. But if you're lucky, the orange will go to the university. So you want to get oranges here more often than not. And all of these guys, I believe, over here can be orange. So yeah, just get oranges. They're the only ones that are going to go forward. Everybody else there usually will go backwards. And some of the oranges can go backwards as well. Last but least, but not least, are these two. There's this lady here who's not active right now, but you can take my word for it. That is a customer. And this guy. These guys, both of them can be solid green or light green, and it's good to know about them, or good to be aware that they're here, because sometimes you can get really bad RNG on the hills, and just, you know, you test your luck and pick up solid greens and just end up going backwards with all of them. And it's good to keep these guys here just in case, you know, you don't want to take your chances with the hills, or you run out of customers somehow on the hills, but you still have more trips over the freeway, and you still want to keep doing loops. If you end up going to, say, the fire station or the tennis courts, these two are a pretty short trip away, or relatively short trip away from that location, or from those locations. So you can kind of, if you need to, have these two as a backup for continuing your loop, rather than, you know, somebody else, some of the other unreliable guys, or if you run out of customers, I guess, in those areas. So, yeah, I like to kind of save them towards the end of the game, and then depending on how the game is going, I may save them for that purpose, or just get them when I go to university. You know, if it's towards the end of the game, I've only got like one more or two more loops around the freeway left, and I don't need these guys as a backup option, then I will just turn around when I'm at the university and get them. And I guess that's pretty much it. That's all. If I went around the entire map and explained all of the key customers on the map. Obviously, I didn't go over a lot of the oranges or yellows specifically, like I did with the greens, but they're not really as important. They're not really that great for doing loops around the map, of course. But it's like you can pick them up too while you're doing loops if you have to. You know, it's not really that bad. You don't have to go for just the green. Sometimes you can get an orange that'll take you to an area that will have a green that you want to get, or another good customer you want to get. So just know that you don't have to only go for those customers that I showed off. But those are the most useful ones for actually doing circuits around the map. We're going to do a little demonstration, I guess, really quickly, of a loop around the map. And I'll just kind of actively show my thought process. I usually get these guys first. Actually, no, I usually get these guys first. What am I saying? One of these greens. Going to Seaside Markets. We're just going to do one quick loop here. We'll see what the game has in store. This is an example of how to do a loop properly. Now, what I would do, first and foremost from Seaside Market, is come back and actually... Well, I guess you have two options here. You can go back to the hills over there, or go get one of the greens on the beach. Now, as I said before, I do find the ones on the hill to be a bit more annoying to get, so... You might just want to go back up to that first hill there and get one, but we'll get one here down here on the beach.
Hey, come here. Thanks.
Or in the ocean, I should say. Anyway, he's no longer on the beach. Going from Tower Records, or to Tower Records. Let me just play really badly too, while I do this. Not really much to say here. Give myself a rest, I guess. So, wait, this wasn't very good. Okay, well, actually, this is fine. Now we could try to get one of these guys. Like I said, there's a few greens over here. I could see that this green right in front of me is active. So he's good to get. I'm going to go back here, though, and see one of these other greens are active. And one is, so we'll get him. Goes all the way to Baseball Stadium. Which is nice. Usually I would have just gone for that light green there, but... You know, I'm trying to, for the sake of demonstrating, I went for that other one instead. Okay, now that we're at Baseball Stadium, like I said, I tend to get one of these customers, or I guess you can really get any of them that I showed off that can be inactive. It's good to get them first, that way you can avoid having to try and make them active later on if you need them. So I got this guy. Just gonna use that trick to drive around the freeway. Still doing pretty poorly. But hug the wall here. Borders, which is this way.
Let's go.
Yeah, just a second. It's your lucky day.
Very nice. And now, as you can see, both of these customers in front of me are green, so I know this lady is good to get. She goes all the way to Lookout Tower. Kind of weird playing without any music. Should have started up some song or something. Alright, now that we're over here, you can see this lady behind me is yellow, so she's going to go to the tennis courts, so I'll get her. God, I'm running into everything. I'm not really trying right now, honestly. Okay, like I said, oranges here are good to get. This lady's probably gonna go to fire station, but I'll get her anyways, just so I can show off the hilly area here, and or the fire station, I guess, depending on who's at the fire station. Nice and easy, you'll do nice drift into this area. Kind of a poor drift. Now, I do like to... I typically, when I'm at the fire station, I will go for these guys first, since the fire station guys, as we saw, can be a little bit RNG-dependent. We got lucky, and the first one we saw was light green, so we'll get her.
Honey, take me to the university.
Okay, but don't freak out on me.
Coo-hoo! Ow! Come on now, can't you see? Come on now,
yeah,
ow!
Yeah, I got it.
Pay more attention. Yo!
And then once we end up at the university, we will have basically completed an entire loop of the map. And we'll just do it again from there on out. You know, I get one of these guys here, go for the green instead, gonna go to the seaside market again, and just rinse and repeat until you get all the greens, and you do as many loops around the map as you can. I'm just gonna quit. That concludes the arcade map portion of this tutorial. Okay, so on to original now. There's not really going to be that much to talk about, as much at least, much like strategy-wise for original. I'm just going to go over some basic navigation tips and some customer tips. I'm going to show off where a lot of the sort of hidden and out-of-the-way customers are as well, and just whatever else I can think of. There's no real script here or plan necessarily. Full disclosure, though, I am recording this part of the video a better part of a year after the other part of the video. I had originally recorded an original tutorial bit, but after rewatching it recently, I didn't really think it was that great, so I'm going to do it again. And I haven't played Crazy Taxi in a while, so I might be a little bit rusty compared to the previous tutorial bit. So yeah, luckily I don't usually forget how to play Crazy Taxi. It only takes like one or two games to get back into the groove, but that's okay. So I'm not really going to be demonstrating any real skill here. Let's make a save state. So yeah, original mode. First things first, the map is basically laid out like a big, I guess, quote-unquote maze. It's not really that difficult to navigate once you play it enough times, but unlike the original map, or the arcade map, sorry, which is one big circle, everything's spread out in the original map. I think I'll probably have a link down in the description below to an image of the original map so you can get an idea of what it looks like. I've gotten a lot of comments over the years about people having trouble navigating the original map, and I guess that makes sense if you haven't played it as much. It's easier to get lost, especially since the arrow doesn't always work properly. And I get the feeling they didn't really program the arrow right for this map. So sometimes it doesn't actually point you in the right direction. Well, generally it points you in the right direction, but sometimes there's better routes to take that it just doesn't tell you to go that way. It'll tell you to go around a lot of times. So yeah, original. The basic strategy I like to use with original is to get green customers first, generally. They give you more money, of course, and more time. You want to build up as much time as you can in the early game to use to get all the like orange and yellows and reds that aren't going to give you any time or any money later on in the game to maximize your score. And so, yeah, I like to get a lot of the greens first. I don't always go out of my way to get greens, but most of the time in the early game I will. And there's another reason for that too, is the fact that a lot of customers on the map have the potential to be green, but they're not always green. And the way the original map is, it's not like the arcade map in the sense that getting greens at certain areas can actually be detrimental to you, where you actually want to kind of plan out like the greens you get, because they're going to take you to certain areas of the map or take you forward or backwards through the loop, or around the loop rather. The original map's not really like that. You don't really have to think about it as much. You just have to play well, and generally things will work out okay. So, yeah, here we are at the top of the hill, where you start off at Big Hills Park. There's usually a few greens hanging around up here. Always best to get these guys while they're green, because I think they can be other colors. So like I said, that's just something you're really going to have to acquire by playing the game a lot, is knowing which customers can be green, which ones won't. I'll go over some of them as I see them, but I'm not going to go over every single customer on the map. So the first kind of hidden out-of-the-way customer is just up here, right behind Big Hills Park. Pretty easy to miss this guy, since you have no reason to go up there other than to get him. And I don't even think the camera really ever shows up there that often anyways, so let's just work our way down here, I guess. Down these streets, I like to call these the big hills. And this just takes you all the way down to where Smith, the Smith Club and the used car lot is. So actually, let me go back up here, go to East Village Station, so we can talk about East Village Station a little bit. Not really much to say here, but I'm just going to show off that there are quite a few greens in here, for starters. These guys are kind of unreliable. They're not always green, but there's also these two customers back here in this corner that are also very easy to miss, since you don't really go into this corner very often, and a lot of times they're not even here. And, what was I going to say? Yeah, that's pretty much it. Just be aware that there's two extra people over here. Like, later on in the game, you'll run out of these guys that are in the grass, and it's a really big time waster to go to East Village Station a lot, since it's kind of just a big empty area for the majority of the game. But it's good to know there are two extra people, like, over there. Another thing worth noting is to be careful when you're making a turn into East Village Station, because there's this cheeky little phone booth here that has been the bane of my existence many a times. I can't remember if I actually went over this. I think I did in the other part of the tutorial, where if you drift into objects like phone booths or boxes, whatever kind of movable objects there are, you have a chance of bouncing off of them, and I've done that countless times while going up this hill and trying to drift into that little corner there, which can be kind of a tight corner to actually make, like this. See if I can actually do it, and you bounce off. So something to look out for when trying to make this turn. When coming up the hill, it's actually kind of a tight turn. Let's see. So this intersection here is kind of complicated. It's like a five-way intersection. You got East Village Station there. This is one of the side streets, which we're going to go over next. It's another side street, and this goes back up to Big Hills Park. And of course, that goes down to... Nope, not there. See, even I get confused. This way. No, that's East Village. I don't know where I am. This way goes back down to the Smith Club and the used car lot. So let's go over this side street here. This one's pretty simple. It just goes straight across the map, basically. Right above where Fila will be. And this is another hidden customer over here, quote unquote, since the arrows are never going to point you down these streets. So if you never go down them, you're never going to know that that guy is going to be there. But he's always there, pretty much, and he's always green too, which is nice. So this will take us right above Fila. And there's Fila. And then behind us is going to be like Pizza Hut, like right up here. So let me show off a nice little route I like to take sometimes. Is when I'm going from the park area, like where the camping grounds are and the camp station and whatnot. When I go from there to the Marine Museum, I generally like to go up the hill. So let's go down here where the camping grounds actually are. I generally like to go up the hill here and go straight this way. And then make a turn here, and then make another turn here. This will pretty much take you right to the Marine Museum. I don't think the arrows actually point you this way. I don't believe, but this is how I like to get from there to here, which there are some customers like in that area or beyond that area, actually, that want to go to the Marine Museum. And that's how I like to do it. So let me go back to those side streets real quick so I can show off some other stuff. So let's go down this one again that we were just on, where that green customer was. He's the only guy here. You can see sometimes he's also light green. Generally best to get him while he's dark green. So this side street is a bit more complicated. It does go all the way through like the other one does, and it kind of puts you, I think, right below Fila. So right across from Levi's. And Fila's going to be like right up there. But there's also another street we just passed while going down this one. And there's another customer here, another solid green. I'm pretty sure this guy is also pretty much always solid green. But again, if you never go down these side streets, which the arrow doesn't tell you to go down, you're probably going to miss this guy. But if you go down this way, you're going to go, it leads you to another side street, or middle street, whatever you want to call these. I don't know what to call these. I always call them side streets. there's another green customer here, though, of course. So this connects two of the streets in the middle of, I guess we can consider the main streets of this area. One of which is this one, with the big steep hills, and the other one's the one that has like Fila and Levi's and KFC and all those other like destinations on it, and I guess Pizza Hut at the very top. So this street in particular is pretty useful when you're going to the Smith Club, because the arrows, like I said, you can't really trust the arrows on this map. They're going to tell you to go around, like down this way, and past the used car lot, and then left here, which is significantly slower than making a turn onto this street and just going straight to the Smith Club. This is way faster. But the arrows will never tell you to actually do that. And it's worth noting there are some more customers here. I think there's like three. There's this one. There's that one there, which you can see is green. But a lot of these guys are pretty unreliable for being green. And there is another guy. I thought there was one here, but I don't actually see the character model. Or maybe it's over here. Not 100% sure. I'm pretty sure there's a third customer here. But I'm a little rusty, so. There is this guy actually here, but you could see him from the KFC, I think. Or maybe not. Anyway, let's go up to Levi's. Again, a lot of greens here on the streets. Just gotta pay attention to who can be green through playing. There's a green there, there's a green here. These guys are pretty common. I guess I should point out this guy while I'm up here. There's two customers at the Fila. This one that's right in the front, and this guy who's over here. A lot of times this woman is actually green, so I always try to pick her up while she's green, as you do. Another kind of hidden customer is over here at Levi's, back here. At least she's on. I think last time I recorded this she wasn't actually turned on, but that's okay. Very easy to miss her unless you know she's there. And then we'll go down to, I guess we'll go down to the Waven Beach area. There's not really much else to say about this street. Just goes up and down. There's some greens on it. There is, this customer here is actually pretty reliably green. It's good to know they're there. Now over here at Waven Beach, not really a whole lot to say. But there are a lot of greens over here, as you can see. A lot of customers that have the potential to be green, so gotta look out for them. Especially like up here. I think these ones are a bit more easily missed compared to the other customers in this area. Since they don't always load in when you drop somebody off. Like, say you drop somebody off right here, you won't actually really see those other guys. See? Like, they're not loaded anymore. So you drive a little bit farther forward, and you can see them. And they're pretty consistently green. Or at least they have the chance to be. I think there's another one actually here, like this guy in the white t-shirt and the blue jeans. He also is potentially green, but he's not really a hidden customer, I guess. I'm about to run out of time already. That was fast. So, let's see. So this big street here, there's one kind of big, long, wavy street from here at the bottom of the hill, kind of at, where the coast is, from the Waven Beach that runs all the way past Pizza Hut, past Big Hills Park, and kind of all the way down to where the downtown area is, where like Square Park, or not Square Park, that's the other that's the other map, isn't it? Yeah, King's Park. King's Park is what it's called. And this is probably the best area of the game in order to get crazy throughs, because it is just like really long and wide open. So sometimes when I'm going to, like, say, Pizza Hut or the Marine Museum, it is technically faster to take some of these other side streets here, which I'll show off in a little bit. But sometimes I'll actually purposely take this outer road here because it's just very easy to get a lot of crazy throughs. As you can see, the turns are relatively gentle. I just ran into somebody. But you can go pretty fast and get a lot of combos here. And this can continue all the way up here if you're potentially going to, say, South Parking Station. It is South Parking, yeah. It is South Parking Station over here. Or any of the other locations, like, in the downtown area. You can get a ton of crazy throughs here. Which is good for building combos. Of course, and making money, and that's the name of the game, isn't it? And this goes all the way down here. Lots of crazy through potential. So that's something to think about when you're going to different locations is sometimes going out of your way to get those crazy throughs. That's really the only area of the map where you're going to want to do that anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. So I guess I'll go back to the Marine Museum. There are, actually, let me show off these guys. Obviously, there's two greens I just passed up. This one was green a second ago, or light green, but now they're yellow. But there are two more greens down here. Keep that in mind. I think they both can be solid green. There's also this guy. I think he's also solid green sometimes, and this guy here, too, is obviously green. And there's another green customer over here. Kind of easy to miss since he's just there by himself, and you're generally going to be speeding through this area. So this is the first side street. This is where we just were earlier when I showed you the route from the camping ground to the Marine Museum. And there are... I didn't really want to pick this guy up, but that's okay. He still shut up, the dude telling me I'm going to run out of time. There are a couple customers here, too. There's this guy. And I think there might be another one, but it's good to just go down these streets and see. I'm not going to go back and forth on them to, like, load all the customers, but there are customers on almost all of these streets here. This one's a bit more common to go down than the other one I just went down is, because this goes in front of Tower Records. Well, there is another green customer there in front of Tower Records. But as you saw, there are, I think, two more customers, I want to say, on this street, too. Let me see. Yeah. That person was just red. Oh, maybe it was her. But there are two customers there. There's a lot of greens over here by the Marine Museum as well. This guy, whose twin is currently in my cab. And this guy. And this woman. And there's another one over here at the corner. Who's pretty consistent. I think they're pretty much always green. So where does this street, I think, connects up to the street I was just on. Yeah, in front of Tower Records. Don't really go that way very often, because there's no reason to really connect in this direction, I guess, unless I make a wrong turn. This side street lets you out in between where KFC is and the used car shop, and is my preferred method to get to the Marine Museum when I need to go faster, instead of taking, like, the outside area past the Waven Beach. You know, if I want to get combos, I'll go left, but if I want to go faster, I'll generally go right and then make a left here, and it's going to save you a little bit of time to get to the Marine Museum that way, because you're not taking as long of a path. So it's worth noting that is another way to go instead of taking that outside path. But this street is otherwise pretty useless since there's not a single customer on it. It's like the only place in the game that's like that. So let's go over here to the islands. I think I've... Let me think real quick. Actually, let me show off one more thing in this area. People I think are pretty easy to miss are the customers on the hill. There's one here, and there's some others, like, kind of towards that entrance area to the where the camping ground is, but I'll show those off later. But there are a couple of customers on the hills here that are easy to miss, I think, because you, again, usually kind of zoom past this area so fast, you might not always see them, or they might not always be loaded when you're here, or actually active, rather. But he's there. I think that guy can be green. Right now he's yellow. And there's this guy here. So, yeah, let's go to the island real quick. There's quite a few easy-to-miss customers here that you're not really going to see in general gameplay unless you go out of your way to actually get them. Now, if you're coming from this direction, like down the hill, you're pretty much always going to want to take the jump here. Unless you're going to the lighthouse, then you kind of want to cut across. It's not always optimal to take the jump, but if you're going from this direction, most of the time it is. Unless you're going to the lighthouse, in which case you're going to want to just go into the water. It's going to be a lot faster just to go straight this way towards the lighthouse. Let me go back over there real quick. When you're going, or conversely, when you're going the other way, it's going to be a lot faster just to go in the water, as opposed to go out of your way to take the jump, because you could just kind of go down here and then go straight any direction you want to go. I didn't want this guy. Unfortunately, I'm going to drive you in the complete opposite direction from Tower Records. So, good to keep in mind that you don't really want to take the jump. Unless you want to get a couple extra points, it's best to just go through the water. Now, if you're going from here to any of the other locations on the island, or if you're just trying to pass the island, then yeah, it's going to be best to take the jump. Let's see another hidden customer up here that probably everybody knows about. Is this lady. She's, I think, almost always solid green. I think sometimes she could be light green. I don't know. I can't remember. But right down here in this area is another green customer right there. If we go around this side of the island, oh, you can see the first underwater customer down here. I usually don't approach him from this side, but this guy's here. I believe he always goes to the Marine Museum. Unless I'm wrong about that. The other one of the two underwater customers does. There's this guy around here, very easy to miss, and there's another customer here that's also pretty easy to miss. Another good one is this guy here. Again, just kind of out of the way, not really near a destination per se. And there's also a couple that can spawn in this area too. And these are generally some of the last ones I get on the island, which is what I kind of refer to this whole area as, since it is an island. Now, something about the island is it's one of the first locations I feel that, when I play, usually runs out of customers or starts getting pretty scarce pretty quickly, so it's good to know where some of these out-of-the-way guys are, just so you can get every single one of them. Lighthouse, as you can see, has quite a few green customers, but these guys are not always green, so keep an eye out for that. There are a couple more, too, like over here, that are kind of unreliable. That guy is solid green. That's pretty rare. There's also this guy here, the baseball man, who can be active as well. So just remember, there's a lot of, you know, potential options if you run out of customers, say, in the actual Marine Plaza itself, which is like one of the central locations of this area. There are still more customers kind of dispersed throughout. There's another underwater customer. Maybe he goes to the Marine Museum, I don't know. You can pick him up and find out yourself. Not really much to say about the Marine Plaza, but it's good to make this jump over here. I think you can actually jump straight up that like sheer cliff if you're going fast enough. So it's worth noting that. Let's see. So, the landing pier. Not really much to say about the landing pier, but I want to point out the fact that there's a lot of stuff here to bounce off of. I'll see if I can actually demonstrate, maybe. I'll make a save state. And, well, I just ended up picking somebody up. I wasn't going nearly fast enough. This is actually something I forgot to mention at the Marine Museum. Earlier, when we were looking at East Village Station, I showed off the phone booth and bouncing off the phone booth. There's a lot of objects over here to bounce off of, too, which will completely ruin your day. Well, apparently I just went right through them. Not what I wanted to do at all. In fact, pretty much the opposite of what I wanted to do. Just be really careful when working or dropping somebody off here at the Marine Museum, or the landing pier, because it's pretty easy to fall into the water. I'm trying to demonstrate, like, doing a bounce here, but it's just not working for me. Nope. We'll just waste some time real quick, why not? It does happen to me a lot, but I don't know. Whatever, you get the idea. So just be careful when dropping people off here about how you drift into that wall. Because if you fall off here, it's a huge waste of time. And for certain customers, you might not even have enough time to get them back up here. I think most of the time you will, but you're going to waste like a solid, like almost like 10 seconds. I want to say 5 to 10 seconds to get back up here. Because you're going to have a lot of momentum going in the wrong direction. Who knows what direction you're actually going to be facing when you fall in. It's just a mess. So, worth noting over here, another hidden customer is this guy over here. He's kind of cheekily hiding behind these boxes. Super easy to miss that guy. He's probably one of the last hidden customers I actually found on the map. But, yeah. Police station area. Not much to say here. There are quite a few potential green customers, though. Like this one. I think this guy, or a lot of these guys, actually can be green, so just keep an eye out for that. There's nobody else, like, down here, so I don't know why I'm going this way. I guess to show off that there's nobody down here. Let's go towards the bank. There's another couple greens at these corners here. This lady and this guy. I believe that guy can also be green. Down this street, which is... doesn't really go anywhere, honestly. It's just in between where the police station is and the bank. There are a couple customers here that are pretty much always green. This guy and one more over here. Yep. Those guys are very consistent. They're always green, I'm pretty sure. And then if we go over here... up these stairs, there's another hidden customer hiding up here, who's orange. I believe she goes to, like, the Marine Plaza, so she kind of sucks. Anybody that goes to the Marine Plaza from here, which is, like, most of the orange and yellows in the downtown area, or a lot of them, kind of suck. There's another customer here at the corner. He's often very solid green, so don't pick him up while he's yellow. There's another green here. And this is the bank. Now, for some reason on original, this is one of those areas where the arrow just doesn't work. If you're going down the street that I just came down, the arrow will be pointing in literally the opposite direction the whole way, so don't believe that. This is the best way to go to the bank. Whatever way the arrow tells you to go is just wrong. Not much to say about the bank. There's quite a few customers over here, though. Some of them aren't active that are along this wall here. And there are some more customers in this area, which are, I guess, somewhat easy to miss since you don't really go over here all that much, I guess. Yeah, so... is there anything else to say about this area? There is a customer, I just paused it there, right there on the corner. That's kind of easy to miss as well. And Millennium Tower, not really anything to say about this area. But there are quite a few customers here. There should be... this guy here is not active. I think there's, like, at least three or four. Him, and there's one more over here. But yeah, I'm about to run out of time, so I'm going to restart real quick and come back over here with more time, I guess. Okay, so we're back here, kind of outside where the Millennium Tower is. We're going to talk about the jump real quick. Now, if you're going from any area this side of the map, I guess, to the park or to, like, the downtown area where the... like the big square area of the map, where it's, I think it's more of a diamond, isn't it? No, I guess it is like a, I don't know, like a cross. When you look at the actual map, and in my head it's like a square. You're always going to want to take the jump. The only time you're not going to take the jump is if you fail the jump, and it's faster at that point just to go around. So the jump here, sometimes there can be traffic blocking the jump. Most of the time it's going to be clear. There seems to be, like, the game will... like, I don't know if this is how this works on every version of Crazy Taxi, but at least on the GameCube version, there's always a car rolling over another car, like, by the ramp, or there's, like, a bus that'll come and, like, stop right before the ramp. So you just gotta not worry about it. Like, there's the bus right there. Oh, no, it stopped in front of the ramp. Maybe I got that mixed up a bit. That seems to happen a lot. Let's see if I can get the other scenario there where the car is rolling over another car. Now that I've said that, it's probably not going to work. Actually, let me make a save state here so I can just reload here again in case I need to. And we did not get the car. Well, that's okay. Just take my word for it. That happens a lot. No idea what just happened there. Let's reload the save state. So the jump's pretty straightforward. The only thing you want to be careful with is actually jumping perfectly straight. Because if you do, and you keep a perfectly straight line... oh, that time I was so good, I went straight over what I was trying to show off. Even when I try to mess up, I can't. That's how good I am at Crazy Taxi. And, oh, I flubbed the jump there. It's good to show off what can go wrong with the jump, though. Don't want to pick you up. Get out. Okay. One more time. This time I'll do it wrong, the way I want to do it wrong. That's like one of the most common ways to fail the jump, though, is to do that. But sometimes this can happen, and that really sucks. You don't want to do this. whatever you do, because it's a huge waste of time to turn around down here in the subways. There's never any reason to go down to the subways, and I'll go over that in a little bit more detail later. I feel like I tend to do this while going over this direction more than I do the other direction. Like going into the subway there, it's just a bit easier, I think, to do that while going this way. So, don't ever do that. Just try to control yourself a bit while going over the building so you don't line up perfectly with the subway. So here's another hidden customer up here. This guy, I think I've said this for all these guys. I think they all do go to the Marine Museum. I could be wrong. But I think this guy actually does go to the Marine Museum. A lot of these guys, these green, hidden, like, spiky-haired dudes, the other two guys are underwater also, the same model, go to the Marine Museum. Nothing else up here. So in the park, not really too much to say. This is King's Park. Got the cafeteria over there. There's a few customers around here. And just like on the opposite side where the bank is, there's a couple customers in this little island, land island, or Rhode Island area. Not much to say about the cafeteria. The cafeteria does have a lot of stuff to bounce off of, too, just like the Marine Museum and the landing pier, so be careful when you're drifting in there, because you could easily bounce out from the cafeteria. Luckily, there's nowhere to really go by the cafeteria, so we're going to lose a couple seconds. Not much to say about the park itself. Be careful not to get stuck on the trees or this little sign if you're going... Actually, where is it? Not this sign. There's like a sign I always get stuck on, isn't there? What am I trying to say? Maybe it's this one. A lot of this stuff can really get in the way sometimes. You won't always like see it when you're trying to just go through the park really fast. So that's really the only thing to look out for. There is a couple of customers back in these corners here that you won't really see unless you go back over here, because they won't load. Same thing with this guy here. Now over here is actually quite a few greens, or potential greens, like this guy. And I think down this street here, this guy, and I want to say this woman here might be green sometimes. Not entirely sure about that. So when making the jump the opposite direction, I tend to go down this street here. I want to say the arrow doesn't actually point you this way. I make a sharp turn like this, and then go over the jump. I'm not actually going to complete it, because I don't want to go that way. But that's how you do that. Now, over here, I'm trying to think, what do I want to talk about over here? So this is like the big square. Actually, you know what? I want to go over here first, and kind of loop back around to where I was earlier. Come full circle, then we'll talk about the square area, I guess. So up this street, there's nobody right here, but there are a lot of greens at this little lot here. There's this guy, and there's another one up here, relatively out of the way, so good to know they're there, and this guy. And this guy. It's four green customers, so try to get them when they're green. Over here at South Parking Station, there's a green there. And a yellow. I think this person's also green sometimes, too. There's also a hidden customer kind of back here. You won't really ever see this guy. He's the person that's like right in front of me. You won't really ever see him unless you come back here, so... When maximizing your score, it's good to know he's there. And then back here, too, you won't really ever see this guy unless you go back here and load him, but... There's a customer right there, too. Unfortunately, whenever I want to show these guys off, they're not active. But a lot of greens over here, too, so... Watch out for that. Another customer here. I think there's one more here on this outer area. Isn't there? Please don't prove me wrong. I suppose there's this guy. This is like close to where Big Hills Park is. I swear there's one like over here that I just missed. Let's see. Like over here maybe? No, maybe not. Well, don't listen to me. Even though this is supposed to be a tutorial. I think there is another customer there somewhere, I swear. That's alright if there isn't. So let's go down here to the square park area. So why do I keep calling it Square Park? It's not Square Park. I want to think square area of a map in the park, and then I say square park. So up here, show off another hidden customer, I guess. So let's go this way. I don't usually get this guy while going on this direction of the freeway, so it's kind of weird for me to visualize this. But on the second place you could jump off, so not right here, but right here, on the roof, there's a customer. And you can jump down onto the roof on the other side, but there's nobody over there. It's just a complete waste. There's really no other reason to go up onto that freeway. Unless you're getting that guy. I'm trying to think if it's possibly faster to ever take the freeway and jump off to get somewhere else. I don't know. I've never actually tested that. But what I have tested is the subways before, which I kind of mentioned earlier. But the subways are a complete waste of time. There's never any reason to go down there. You can take them to get to certain areas, and it's actually much more comparable than I thought it would be than going over land, but it is slower and it's more annoying, so never any reason to go down in the subways. This area is kind of like a big trap, I guess. There's a lot of reds over here that'll just take you to one of these four corners of this area. And it's easy to get stuck in here. But there's also a lot of greens kind of spread throughout, so I would say kind of avoid picking up these reds and only go for the greens if they're here. If not, just kind of go outside this area to get somebody, unless you want to pick up all these reds. But there are, yeah, quite a few greens. Be careful of these guys in the corner. They're probably some of the easier ones to miss over here. Like that guy. Like this lady, I know for a fact she can be green. But in this area, there's not really much else to say. Let's see. Yeah, subways, waste of time. I have glitched up on top of this roof before. I think from this side. Or no, from the other side. And I've tried to get it to work over here. Where I kind of like drift into the wall and just force my way like up onto that roof, which would be a nice way to get that other customer, but I have not been able to actually replicate that on this side of the map. So over here to, what's this called? West Central Station. There's, again, a lot of greens over here. So always try to get the greens, like a ton in this grassy area. And right here. And there is one kind of hidden customer up here who you're never really going to see. And just like the other ones before, he's not active, but it's this guy right here in the orange and green shirt there. So good to know he's up there. Over here in this like pass, little valley pass, there is more green customers. Yeah, see, this guy wasn't even active a minute ago. I want to say that yellow guy can also be green, so. Wait up, where you going? Only get him while he's green. This guy is also pretty consistently green, and I think so is this guy as well. With the flowers. Now, down here is kind of the last, I think. Yeah, I think I've gotten everybody. This is the last hidden customer, and easily the most annoying, and the only reason to go down into the subway. It's also the only subway station, I think, where you have to go down a bend like that. Actually, no, I don't know if that's true. But down here, there's this guy. The one and only dude that's all the way down here in the subway. And it's really annoying. Like, who would ever find that guy? Okay, so yeah, nothing to really say about this area is... These guys on the outside, kind of easy to miss. Like, there's a green over here. I see there's another one kind of down there. Because you go through this grassy area quite a bit here, but you don't really go on the outside all the time, so it's always faster to kind of go this way. It's also worth mentioning that taking the rails is actually a lot faster to get to certain areas than driving on the streets. Like, if you're going to like South parking station, the arrows are gonna point you like up the hill here, but it's worlds faster to like go this way. You could also get to East Village station pretty easily here too. It's not, it's probably a little bit faster, but it's kind of annoying to get to the actual destination drop-off area from the rail. But I mean, to get to South parking station, look how much faster this is. Rather than going up those hills, making all those turns, you just drive in a straight line, basically get there. The same is true from going here to West Central Station. That is what it's called, right? Yeah, West Central. I'm forgetting the names. And or the camp station. It's a lot faster to take the rails. And I guess there are other situations where it's probably going to be faster to take the rails as well. Just depending on who you're picking up and where they're going, I guess. But this is a nice little quick show off of where those go and how those work. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I actually want to cover here, but I don't think there really is. It is actually better to go through this rail here, like this tunnel, as opposed to going around that pass. It's just a bit faster. The only thing that can happen though is you might run into the train in here, which is kind of annoying, but it's worth the risk to save the time, which is what the whole game's about. And yeah, I feel like I'm forgetting like somebody or something on the map, but I don't think I am. That pretty much covers everything. One thing I want to do real quick is show off a fun little glitch of sorts. Oh, actually, there is one customer I forgot to show off. It's this guy. Or girl. That person there under that awning is actually really easy to miss. And I guess I'll show off this too, since maybe not everybody knows about this, but there's a little shortcut through here to go through these boxes, as opposed to going back out the front of the used car lot where there's all these cars and stuff in your way. You just kind of blast out this way. Okay, so we're back here in front of the Waven Beach area to show off a nice fun little glitch where we can kind of ascend into the heavens. This kind of happens at a couple different corners on the original map only. I've never had it happen on the arcade map ever, but maybe it can there too somewhere. Who knows? So let's try it here. This is one of the easier spots to do it. This car would not be in my way. Oh, and we got it first try. Oh, that was kind of lame, though. I fell down pretty quickly. Let's do it one more time. Oh, okay. Don't know how that happened. This is a pretty useless glitch, but this is kind of fun, you know. And, of course, after almost, or getting into my first try, I won't be able to ever get it again. Come on, go! I've actually tried pretty hard in the past to, like, find ways to get out of bounds, but I've never actually been able to do that. Despite how wild the physics are in this game. It's fairly well put together, all things considered. Let's see here. Oops. Oh, why was there a van there? Come on, I want to end this. Yes, there we go. That's a lot better than the first time. Well, that's really all that is. Kind of a waste of time, but I guess that's just about everything I could think of off the top of my head. Hopefully the fact that I haven't played in so long is not causing me to forget some other stuff I wanted to go over, but I think that's pretty much it. So that's the original map. All right, just came back to the menu here, since there's really nothing else to say on the original map. I've covered everything that I wanted to go over. I didn't leave anything important out, any important information. I hope that everything was pretty clear and informative and helpful so that you can become a better Crazy Taxi player. I want to pass my knowledge on to you, whoever you are. because I love this game, and I want more people to play it, and I want people to enjoy it, and to be good at it, and to beat my scores. Yeah, I'm going to be doing more Crazy Taxi content in the future. I'm kind of taking a little break at the moment because, well, I've done a lot this year. but Crazy Taxi 2 will be coming soon, and a few more things in Crazy Taxi 1 as well. As well as eventually, probably someday, probably not for a while, but eventually I will go back to Crazy Taxi 1 high scores as well. So check out some of my best games at this time. My two best games are 105,000 in arcade and 155,000 in original, which I'm very proud of, both of those scores. So yeah, I really hope this was helpful. I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.